Welcome to the 2019 end-to-end Ramsey Bakery race walk. Congratulations to everybody who managed to finish the race. Also to Richard Jarrett for his sixth consecutive, seventh and total victory. Also shout out to Hannah Hunter, who got the record for the women's event under 7 hours for the first time. My father took the video, Graham Young. He's a one man, one camera situation. So please bear that in mind as you try to catch as many of you as possible. Enjoy the video.
With you now is John Cannell. John, if I dare say, your history and the history of the end-to-end go back quite a few years.
Thank you, Graham. Yes, back to 1961, the very first one.
How much experience of walking had you back then?
Probably about a year, maybe.
And how did you get on?
I finished last, 17th and last, 9 hours 29 minutes.
And
very dark when I finished.
Any recollections going back all that time?
Not really, no. I can't remember the very first one, no. It's probably about 30, 40 maybe in the race.
And over the years, the records book tell me that you've completed 15.
Yes, well, I wasn't sure myself. I've done 2 on the present course, and obviously 13 on the other one.
And how do the courses compare in you?
Yeah, talk about this quite a lot. I think the one down the east coast was probably hillier, because you know you got your little hills that you forget about, the Rest and Be Thankful Hill, the White Bridge, and then you got Long Pull up Spring Valley, the Richmond, and then of course the High Road, which is always going to be there. It's hard to say.
And how many you've been victorious on? Numerous occasions?
Yeah, I think so. I really don't know. Probably about 6 or 7 maybe. I'm not too sure.
So the tender age of 15 in that first parish? In the first end-to-end, I should say?
Yeah.
61?
61. Yeah, 16, yeah.
15?
15.
Wasn't it would be before December?
Yeah, it was.
It's probably stunned people these days that somebody of that age could walk virtually 40 miles.
Well, I don't think the age limit had come into it then, if I remember rightly. It was just maybe a little while later that the age limit came into it.
And what was the spirit like in those days?
It was good, yeah. It was very good. Obviously, it was a very first, it was the start of walking over here. Stan Cleeter won it in about 7 hours, 9 minutes, I should say.
And over the years, was it very inspiring, that race itself?
Oh yes, yeah. I mean, the next year I came third. I think I was actually faster than Stan Cleeter's winning time the year before.
That's a massive improvement in a short time.
I think I did 7 hours 13 minutes that year. I finished third.
What happened in that preceding 12 months?
I trained a lot, you know, and well, you know, you were around yourself at the time, you know, so I think the TT relay and things like that got everybody inspired. The parish walk itself, of course.
This year's event, any predictions?
I haven't actually studied the entry list that well. Obviously, Richard Gerrard must be a favourite. But you got James Quirk breathing down his neck and Dave Walker. I just hope the weather's okay, but I believe the forecast is not very good.
What about the ladies' race? Any predictions there?
Hannah Hunter, yes.
With me now is Richard Gerrard, who has just, I think, collected up. You signed on, have you, at the?
Yeah, well, I'm actually on the committee, so I've come down to help out the registration, and at the end of the night, once everyone else has gone through, I'll be signing on then.
So you're here, but you haven't actually done your own registration yet, so you're still on duty.
So hopefully I won't forget before I have to head off home.
So how's the organisation gone this year?
Yeah, it's gone very well. We've got a fairly steady committee now. And kind of the preparation starts earlier on this year, and we only kind of generally meet once a month, but there's a good team in the background, and kind of it's amazing the amount of work that the team put into it to put it together, really. All sorts of things to think about.
How many marshals, for instance, do you require?
There's just over 50 marshals.
Wow.
So even though it's less than half the size of the parish, we still need good support on the day. So I think obviously without all the marshals, everyone else who helps out on the water stations and the likes, all the volunteers, we just couldn't put events like this on.
Your own season this year, Richard, how's it gone so far?
It's been very up and down this year. I've kind of done a bit more running. When I say running, kind of felt running. I always fancied doing the mountain marathon, so that was the kind of focus for the start of the year, and that was at the end of April. So really enjoyed that, and I'm going to have another go next year. But in terms of the walking, I was looking forward to the parish walk. Things were going to plan, probably Kurt Michael way, and then I just got sick. It just hit me, and never kind of had sickness like that before.
I saw the evidence on the road of Bride.
So from being in a position where I was feeling comfortable in the lead to the wheels completely coming off. But I said at the time, never again, but I'll be back next year.
How many times have we heard that over the years?
Numerous.
Yeah. So where does the end-to-end fit in on the scale of things in the season?
Again, the end-to-end is an event I really enjoy doing. So I've kind of got a bit of a dual focus at the moment. As well as doing the end-to-end, I'm also in training for the Amsterdam Marathon. So that's on the 20th of October. So my kind of walking preparation hasn't been the best. I've done a bit more, a bit of a mix of running and walking. So for example, last weekend, I did 18 miles walking on the Saturday and then a 20 mile long run on the Sunday. So not the best preparation, but I suppose it's all miles in the bank. But as I kind of get nearer the 20th of October, I'll be doing some bit more kind of speed work. But end-to-end is certainly an event I wouldn't want to miss.
Why the Amsterdam Marathon?
Well, I did the London Marathon, I've done that a couple of times, and I fancy doing the New York Marathon next year. To do that, unless you try and go through the lottery or the ballot, the chances of that are probably about 1 in 20 of getting in. I thought I'd try and get a good for age time, and Amsterdam is a nice flat marathon, and I can get that done before applying for New York next year.
Do you have a target time?
I'd like to try and go under 3 hours again, but I'm not sure I'll fit at the moment. But I need to get 3:05 to get a good for age time for New York.
So what's the mindset for Sunday? You should have quite a comfortable margin, having, correct me, is it 5 successive wins?
Yep. I don't know. I think I'll kind of see how it goes, probably the first 10 miles, just settle in. And then push on. Then I tend to kind of be stronger in the second half anyway. But I don't know, I suppose there's new people come in, and there'll probably be a couple of people on the day who you're kind of not expecting, or maybe not on the radar. So and then obviously some of the people who've been around for a while, the likes of James Quirk, Tony McIntosh, and then on the lady side, Hannah Hunter, I think. We'll probably do a good walk on Sunday as well. So there's a few people there. So it'll be very, very hard to predict the first three, kind of male and female.
Teddy
was working from home last Friday after he'd been out.
Thank you. come over this side thinking we're going to be on that side.
Morning.
Now is Michael George. Mike is the current record holder for the end-to-end with a time of 6 hours, 24 minutes and 32 seconds, and he has, the stats say on the website, completed the distance on 7 occasions. Mike, what do you recollect about that race in 2013?
I think I was a bit unexpectedly quick, because when I finished there was two men and a dog and Murray Lambton. And my wife just about made it. It was pretty quiet at the Sound Cafe, but it was a race with Richard, who I think is the favourite for Sunday's race. We've both been at it hammer and tongs for much of the year, and we're just coming up towards Dolby Mountain, just when you're still on the coast there, and he just went over to his wife to grab a sandwich, and I just decided to go for it at that particular time, and as my support Nigel Armstrong eloquently put it, stand on his neck, Mike. And I managed to open up quite a gap to him, and won quite convincingly that year.
This year is a little thin, maybe in some ways, on people at the sharp end. Do you feel?
I think in the top class, Richard may very well prove me wrong, but I don't think there's anybody going to push him really near to a fast time. I also know that he's training for the Amsterdam Marathon to run that, so I'm not quite sure that he'll want to even push himself.
What do you? Any ideas, prospects for the ladies' race?
I don't think you can look further than Hannah Hunter. Although the Alaman Marathon winner, Jane Farquhar, she's a very, very fit lady. And while Hannah had the speed, you couldn't say Jane didn't have the endurance. So it might be an interesting match up there, because whether how much volume Hannah would have done, I'm not quite certain. But I would expect her to win, to be honest with you.
What about minor places?
I think in the men's, if James Quirk is still struggling for fitness, I would fancy Mike Reachaw. He's been spotted doing a lot of miles on the road. So I would give him for second, maybe James Quirk for third. And the minor places, as I said, I would expect Jane Farquhar to come second. There's some difficult ones, because some people have done the 100 miles, so I can't really see the likes of Steph Burton and Sophie. Can't quite get a name. It's an Eastern European.
That's the training partner with Mark Hemsel.
Yeah. And whether that doing that walk, I don't think he'd be pushing his own PB, but perhaps that might bring Mark Hemsel into play for top 10 places, maybe even top 5. Regular 100 miles walker.
How about deeper in the field again, Mike?
All the people who could be in the mix, of course, Karen Laurie and Tony McIntosh. They've taken a year out from their ultra walking, but their background fitness and how much they've been doing on a week-to-week basis, I really don't know. But you could never write those two off. As is Stephanie Burton, another one who's done the 100. For a men's top place, a dark horse might be Richard Creer. He has great technique, great speed. But once again, I'm just doubting whether he's quite done the volume that will take him right up to the top echelon.
Thank you, Mike.
I had a bike to
guys.
Down in the dungeon is all we know, where the shining light we never go into the open. As far as you can see, it wasting there, a big bright destiny. Don't you feel like breaking free? Open your eyes, embrace what you see now. Don't you feel like caught in?
Lovely.
With me now, I have Billy Gilbert. He's the winner to Peel.
Yeah.
Billy, how did your race go?
It's quite hard. My neck started hurting around Kurt Michael, and I was feeling quite sick up the Dallas Alba. It was quite tough for a 22 mile.
Did you have a planned set time or?
Roughly 4.5 hours. So just over that. Not too bad in the end.
Many congratulations. Have you had much experience of this?
I've done the Paris twice, but I can only get to Peel.
Right.
And also the Fireman's Walk.
So can I ask you how old you are?
19.
Oh, excellent. So great potential for the future.
No promises.
Very well done.
Thank you.
Thank you. With me now, I have Samantha Oates. Samantha's the under 21 ladies winner to Peel. How did your race go?
It was good. It's alright. Bit tiring, but it's alright.
No issues?
My hip mainly. My hip, like right down my leg. But apart from that, it's been alright.
Feet okay?
Feet fine, yeah.
Very good. Have you prepared very much for it?
Didn't train at all.
Nothing?
Nothing.
So you just took this on the chin?
Yeah.
And have you much experience with this?
I've done the Paris past few years, but apart from
that, under 21s?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Apart from that, nothing.
So you're just going from race to race?
Pretty much.
And if I dare, how old are you, please?
19.
Excellent. So a great future ahead of you?
Maybe, I don't know.
Maybe? No commitment now. excellent. Very well done.
Yes.
Looking good, Paul. How's it going? Looking good. Yeah. How are you feeling, Hannah? How are you feeling?
Good.
Good, good. Okay, got Richard Gerrard here now. You had a very comfortable lead at the end, Richard, but what's the story of the race?
It went off fairly quick at the start. Hannah Hunter set a decent pace, and she was probably nearly a minute ahead of James Quirk and I going to the Kronk. And then from the Kronk to Kurt Michael, I caught up with her and then just moved away after Kurt Michael, and I built a reasonable lead at Peel, and then felt fairly comfortable all the way. But as the weather conditions were perfect today, nice and cool, wasn't too much of a breeze, a little bit of headwind in places, but it couldn't have got much better really. So but yeah, I was pleased with the time today. It was quite a bit quicker than last year,
and yes, yeah,
not too far away from a PB as well.
Very good. So you've not been doing as much walking training, I believe, recently?
No, I've been doing a fair amount of running, but I don't think I was lacking in the fitness. I just wondered how I would feel in the second half of the race with not getting the walking miles in, but fingers crossed. Well, it actually it didn't seem to affect me that much, so no, I was pleased with the way today went.
So no low points as such, or anything worth mentioning?
I didn't feel great on the climb up to the round table, but I don't think anybody does, do they?
So, really.
it wasn't a particularly quick couple of miles, but then after that, up to the top of the slot, kind of settled down again, and then you can race walk a couple of quick miles there down to the bottom of the slot, and then you've only got the nice climb up to Craigneish to look forward to after that.
Congratulations, it's well
thanks
done, and good luck for your Amsterdam marathon.
Yeah, thanks very much, Graham.
You set your stall out from the word go.
Well, I figured that I haven't done hill, so I thought if I walked my walk on the flat to Peel, and then the hills would take care of themselves, really. They'd be what they would be. And then I hit a bit of a wall at Kurt Michael, felt really sick, so Kurt Michael to Peel was going to be really horrendous. And then all I've had is coffee and cola bottles. That's all I could eat.
So you seemed very surprised by how much you've actually gone inside the ladies' record.
Yeah. I obviously knew that's what I would like, but it wasn't what I thought I'd get. I thought it'd be like 7:10, 7:20 or something realistically. I thought the hills would have really caught me. But I just kept plowing. It did feel funny walking uphill.
You're saying that you had problems trying to keep gels down?
I didn't even try any.
No,
it was the water that made me feel sick. My drink that I always have in my 20k, just by Kurt Michael, I was just feeling really sick with it. So I had some coffee, and that's all I could stomach.
So we're catching you on the hop now, you haven't even recovered from this, but the next one? 50k's somewhere along the line.
I really want to do another 50. That's I've got to prove myself to myself in a 50. But I just love walking 80b.
It's always been a favourite, this one, hasn't it?
Yeah.
A massive PB.
Massive. Well, I had to read Richard did 7:17.
Yeah.
So I had to beat that.
And yours was 8:17 previously, I think.
Was it? When I look back.
If you improved an hour, you'd have beaten his.
Right.
Yeah. But what do you do? Much more than that.
Yeah. 6:58 was it? 6:59.
Excellent. Well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Good. Here, you can get shit. Michael James.
With Paul Everton now, Paul finished fourth today, and I understand you're actually in line for a new trophy, a new award, first time finisher.
Right.
It's an award that's only just come up this year. I'm not too sure who it's in memorandum of, but that's reliable information, so many congratulations.
Thank you very much.
How did your race go?
It seemed to go quite well. I think I probably started a little fast at the start to Peel. That went fairly well, and then struggled a little bit up to the round table really, but then from there it just seemed to go a bit more smoothly. Yeah.
What sort of preparation have you done?
I started with racewalk training.
Right.
The parish, that was the first sort of training I did. Did quite all the parish, and then I've done not a lot between the parish and this, but I think I've done enough before to see me through.
So that's all this year?
Yeah, all this year.
Yeah. Very good. So plenty of potential there then.
Hopefully, yeah.
And what persuaded you to take it up in the first place?
It was a guy from work called Bernal, which is big into walking, suggested I give it a go and give me a bit of coaching, a bit of training for the parish, and then that went well, so I'll do this as well.
So you come from a sporting background?
Yeah, I play football for Michael, so...
You still do?
Yeah, because we're at a base level of fitness, but obviously it's slightly different than walking. You do need to do a bit of walk training as well, really.
So what kind of training have you been doing?
A mixture of... When I was training for the parish mainly, it was either like two shorter walks a week, 6 to 10 miles, just like fast, and then one long walk. And between the parish and this, I've done one or two a week, really. Mainly shorter walks, the odd longer ones.
So how did the parish go?
Well, finished 8th.
No legacy injuries? Or?
No, it was all fine. I was lucky enough to get the most improved award on that one, actually, so I'm quite pleased to get another one now as well.
So you've done the parish previously?
Yeah, I did the parish in 2015, did a time of about 21 and a half hours, and then managed to get under 18 hours this year.
Massive improvement, yeah, excellent. So many congratulations.
Well, thank you very much.
Done. Cheers.
Very much.
Tom. Alright.
Hey boy, how are you?
Yeah, I'm alright. Yeah.
Alright.
It's crap from that field.
Yeah.
Like, stopped going up there. I just by the houses, stretched out.
Well done.
There
you go. Cheers, matey. Thank you. That's a hard day.
Has Karen come in?
No, she's Dave's bumped some of the car, so they're now swapping cars and trying to. I haven't had any backup since Dolby.
With me now is Chris Byrne. Chris, how did the race go?
Race went really well. First half went with Tony, good pace. Then into Peel, I felt really good. And I had a bit of a spurt on, and second half was one of my better races. Overall, really well, and the only minor problem was probably the last couple of miles, which was to be expected, coming up to the sound, and I was safe anyway, so there wasn't any issues of being overtaken or losing its place. So overall, my best race to date. Position and best time.
Excellent, well done, congratulations.
You killed me. Girls as well.
Get anyone's off.
James Quirk, third on the road, second man.
Yeah.
How did it go?
Yeah, as well as can be expected, I think. You know, I've spoke to you before, Graham, about the injury.
Yeah.
After the parish. So I was mindful of that today. And I think possibly just in the early stages, technique wise, maybe putting a bit too much weight, compensating, overcompensating with the left leg to protect the ankle a little bit. And it was a bit tight. I thought I'd climb better later on. But just protected everything and happy enough to get a third.
And you've just come off the massage slab.
Yeah.
You had your money's worth there, I think.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
I was just amusing myself at the grimaces. Yeah. I think you could go in a gurning competition. Just
put a
horse's collar on your head.
I could have cleaned up today. I think not won the race, but I might have won the ugliest face.
Well, yeah. I don't know about ugly, but it was amusing.
Yeah. Glad you enjoyed it.
I did. Oh, yeah, every second. Yeah, to say it's an absolute painometer. So, how did the massage go?
Yeah, massage was brilliant. I mean, the guys give their time up for free, and you know, the best you can do is put a bit of money into their box for charity. But I've made the mistake many years ago of just finishing, getting into a car, and going home. And I've been at the side of the road with Christine at Foxdale in agony.
Yeah.
Spent the whole night then in agony. So. Although they put you through a bit of a punishment.
Yeah,
it's definitely what's required at the end.
But it's fantastic they've got these sort of facilities these days, isn't it?
That, I think the organisers do well to...
I mean, as you cross the line, there's three benches there.
And again, I apologise, I don't know the guys this year, but Glenn's been here ever since I've been doing it, and I did have a break very early on. Came back to it in about 2014. I think Glenn's been there ever since 2014, and I know he was there years ago. So, yeah, he really puts the effort into this race and provides his time.
The old injury itself, how did that stand up? The Achilles?
It's okay. Yeah, it didn't show at all. Show is a word I've got to know with spending a bit of time at the hospital having scans and what have you. But yeah, the ankle is fine. I'm rotating it now. I know you can't see that on camera, but absolutely no issue with it at all. Confident now that maybe it's on the mend. Have a good winter training wise. And it's nice to get a finish, last big race of the year. So look forward to the finals.
Is this your seasonal peak? As in planning and.
Yeah. I mean, after the parish, I really wanted to finish this one. I know 20 mile ago, I was questioning myself whether I was going to or not. But regardless of position today, I just wanted to finish it. So I was going into the winter season for the smaller 10Ks if I take part. But knowing that next year, going into the Fireman's in April, that the distance was in the legs and I can carry that forward. Massive well done to Richard and Hannah this afternoon. Hannah won and walked an incredible race. For somebody who doesn't really do this distance, or 3 or 4 years ago now since she's done the distance. And Richard just today showed what a competitor he is. I walked with him to around about the Cronk. And then from there on, he just left us and set a really good time. So well done to Richard Hannes.
Oh, I absolutely agree.
Thank you.
Well done, everybody.
Graham.
Well done, fella. Well done. This is slightly cruel, but Paul's only just crossed the line and I've managed to persuade him to sit down and say a few words to us. How is the race, Paul?
Yeah, it's good for me. I was surprised myself, really, because I only entered at the 11th hour, literally in about 10 minutes before the cut-off time for entries. And I've really only done this on the back of doing the Yorkshire Trainingpeaks walk.
Yes.
Which is like a 24-miler. And I was fancy doing the end-to-end. So normally my role in supporting other people, so like my wife, for example, who would have normally walked today, but she's injured, and my cousin Graham, who comes over from the UK to do some of the local races. But this year was good for me to have a go myself. Say I'm back at some off-road walking that I've been doing. And so yeah, really surprised myself, really. I felt quite strong. And finished really well.
But technically it looked okay to me, I saw of it. Very compact, looked efficient, and
yeah.
You do come from an illustrious gene pool of walkers. Your uncle was a fantastic 50k walker.
Yeah.
But you're mostly fell runner?
Yeah. Mostly fell running, and I've done the parish walk once, probably about 10 years ago. Mostly running, bit of road running, but largely, fell running really is my first love in athletics.
So this is a debut on the end-to-end?
It is, yeah. It's the first ever end-to-end, and really enjoyed the experience, and I think the weather was much better than was forecast, and so conditions were good out there, and I got into some good battles early on, but for the large part of the race I was very much on my own. Brings about its challenges, of course, in terms of just keeping motivated, keeping focused, but kept going to the end.
So which direction do we go from here? Is it back to the fells, or have you got a little taste for walking now?
Well, I'll probably dabble in walking from time to time, usually when I'm struggling with the running, because I'm prone to injuries now, getting a bit older, but I do find the walking less harsh on the joints, so it's quite a refreshing change to do something a little bit different.
Did it! Was so fast! Was it? Hey, 21! Welcome! Come on, guys!
tough, is it?
It is, yeah. Fortunately, the time will be correct each for you, okay? Yeah, sorry.
25.
Right.